keeping the game in front of them, because anything they have given up as they face, their backs are to it trying to defend.
Flores, he wanted to give it a hit. Riley finds Keel! First shot on target of the match. Quick trigger. Saved, though, by Dominguez. Now Bynum on it. Passes off, though. Easily picked off by Hooper. And Conor Gradillas turns it over, and this finds the legs of Bynum again. He's got Pinoza with him. Bynum on the right foot. Gives it a shot. Wide. Flores gets it in back post. They got room. Headed down and in! Oh, off the training ground. What a beauty! Adden heads it back across. And it ends up in the back of the net.
This is very clever from Stanford. Everybody's in an offside position to start it. So as a defender, you're going, okay, where's the movement going to come from? And you forget about the sleeper on the backside. That is Noah Adden. Just a beautifully weighted ball to the back post. All you're asking for is the trailing runner on the spin. You got to get perfect timing here. And as he floats it through, he's just redirecting it onto frame.
Redshirt junior from San Diego. Spent 10 years abroad playing soccer at some big-time clubs. Chelsea, obviously the Premier League, Fulham as well. Lived in Switzerland, Japan, played in high-level clubs.
We talked about this last week for SMU. 9 games for them. 4-1-4. That's the key impactful moments of what you can do when it matters most, which is why you've got a team sitting in the top 5 compared to a team that's right at 15 trying to drag themselves in.
Pino to take it in.
Oh! Stabby let it go! And Pino equalized in shocking fashion! The keeper hangs his head! And the fans to their feet! Sometimes you just want to throw it in a danger area and allow someone to run onto it, see what happens. Overhits it as a cross, underhits it as a strike, but you're still making the goalkeeper commit to one of those special moments we just talked about, and Schnellman just loses it.
The Cards are hungry. A lot of players were in those games hungry to avenge those losses. Pino again on the set piece.
That's a ball.
Dangerous ball, it hit the bar! And Ribeiro says no goal! He can look at this as well. Did the ball cross the line? And he is pausing the game to do so.
That is,
I believe it was Zarnik with a great ball in.
It's,
I
mean, an incredible ball.
Pino ball in and then Zarnik head on it. We'll take a look.
A ton of pace behind it. Pino, what a ball back across right on the edge of the six. And that actually comes off the back of the head of Palmer Bank. I can't tell, though, as to whether or not that crosses the line from that angle.
After final review, the ball, it crossed the whole line and touched with the black wheel of the goal. So I'm going to go goal.
He's saying it did cross the line. He referenced the wheel that you could see in the goal. Big center back into the box. He is their main target. Flicked on, back post, to Flores is there, off the post, back in! Jackson Keel, the Flores strike partner, Johnny on the spot, and we are locked up at deuces.
And this team has seen it. They've gone down before and they found a way to come back. The Clemson game for sure, long throw. Another makeshift set piece. I mean, every single opportunity tonight for these teams from dead ball situations, they've made the most of. Great job on the redirection to the backside.
Can they do it again off a long throw?
You know, Will Cleary's done a really good job the last two sequences of freeing himself up. He's right at the penalty mark.
And Dominguez pulls it in. A lot of traffic around Dominguez. The ball played in, Dominguez comes off with a punch. First time shot in, just wide. From Bank, Fletcher. 2-2 is going to be the final. Your thoughts as they split the spoils?
6 games in the ACC tonight, 5 goals, 4 of which came in this game. So we were all spoiled a little bit with the theatrics. But to me, this just comes down to competition.